Has change become the new normal for the European chlor-alkali industry? One of the biggest changes happened in December last year, when we passed the deadline to phase out mercury-based chlorine production. It modernized our sector and improved our energy efficiency. This is something we can all be proud of. However, we're not done yet with mercury, as stabilization and safe final disposal still require our attention. Change is also seen in the many recent investments from our member companies. This highlights the vital role of our industry in Europe's economy, as we provide the essential ingredients to make millions of products. Another change is that my successor will start in 2019, ensuring that Eurochlor maintains a strong voice for the European chlor-alkali industry. At the same time, we will move to the new CEFIC headquarters in the heart of Brussels, placing us near key decision makers and helping us to have our voice heard. However, some things should never change: our absolute commitment to safety. As part of our safety initiative, we're visiting and discussing with our members, and it's delivering. We are identifying areas where we can cooperate even better. We want to ensure that everyone returns home healthy every day, able to enjoy the benefits of working in a safe and successful industry. Chlorine manufacture is an energy-intensive process. We've made impressive gains in energy efficiency, but energy policy developments in Europe still challenge our competitiveness. Our industry needs reliable and affordable energy. We will keep up the pressure for new and competitive energy solutions. I've always felt that Eurochlor's greatest strength is how we combine the deep technical knowledge of our industry with constructive relationships with regulators that build the necessary trust. I'm confident that my successor can rely on the Eurochlor team and on everyone within our industry to continue supporting a safe, sustainable and successful chlor-alkali industry for Europe.